So let's rank the Ice Age film franchise. Big Days Entertainment Rankings and Reviews. So greetings, my fellow YouTubers, and welcome to Big D's Entertainment Rankings and Reviews. My name's Noel, better known to you as the Big D, back with another ranking. Today I'm going to rank the Ice Age film franchise. This has 6 movies. They're saying there's more to come, but, well, let's not jump to any conclusions of this, okay? But anyway, Ice Age was the very first film to be produced by the now-defunct Blue Sky Studios. And I'm going to say this franchise was a blast from start till close to the end because it started to lose steam later on. But anyway, I've now seen all 6 films, so before I get into the ranking, if you haven't seen my reviews for all 6 films, click on the card. It'll take you to the playlist so you can catch what you might have missed or see them again. So far, I've seen that Dawn of the Dinosaurs is already the most viewed review in the franchise. Alright, so we'll see where that winds up with the first one right behind. With the second most views. But again, I'm not telling you where these rank, so you're just going to have to stay tuned and find out. Alright, now, if you're ready, let's get into this ranking. Sit back, relax, and here we go. Coming in at number 6 is... The Ice Age Adventures of Buck Wild, which premiered on Disney Plus earlier this year. I recently watched this, but I didn't think it was good. It was alright, but it just wasn't good, though. Wasn't great or anything. Only Simon Pegg returned. No one else did. They recasted everybody and what have you. You know, another thing I failed to mention in my spoiler-free review of is Peaches is absent as well. No Scrat either. The animation was just dull. It was bland and what have you. Yeah, but Simon Pegg was probably the only thing that saves this from being a total disaster. Yeah. So anyway, Ice Age Adventures of Buck Wild, avoid this at all costs, unless your kids are interested in it. Now coming in at number 5 is... Ice Age Collision Course from 2016. Now if you've seen my review for Adventures of Buck Wild, I said I'd rather rewatch this over that. Anyway, this film didn't do as well as the other ones did. And, well, that's understandable and what have you. Now, they brought Buck back after being absent from the last film. Well, I still thought this film was reasonable. It was factually reasonable, but still not really a great one, though. But I still liked how it turned out with the sci-fi elements of the spaceship and why you Scrat controlling that and causing the meteor to come down. Yeah. That was still pretty good. Some of it was kind of, well, you know, it was kind of a mixed bag for me. So anyway, I think Collision Course was kind of a mixed bag. I didn't hate it much, but I'd rather rewatch this over Adventures of Buck Wild any day. You know what I'm saying? Great. That about covers it. And, well, there were some new additions. Well, maybe a few, but not too many. But even so, I think this is still an okay film. Not the best, though. Now, coming in at number 4 is... Ice Age The Meltdown from 2006, and I apologize for my big lie up there. Yeah, this is the second film in the franchise, and it's still pretty good. I mean, it's just to do well and what have you, and... Well, what can I say? After revisiting this film, it hasn't lost too much of its bounds and its comedy and what have you. It's still got fun moments and what have you. With the addition of Ellie and Crash and Eddie, yeah. This film just made it more fun. With all the craziness and what have you, yeah. I find this to be a little bit of a good film. Well, it kind of just fell right back because the next two films surpassed it, and those two have been the highest. But anyway, I think Ice Age the Meltdown just had a lot more fun than what I could get from even Collision Course or even Buck Wild's Adventures. Still, I think it was just a little fun. Especially since this was just the third film from Blue Sky after they had just done the first film, and Robots, which came out a year before this. So anyway, Ice Age the Meltdown, yeah, it's not too bad and what have you. I still got to enjoy it for what it was, you know. Now, coming in at number three is... Ice Age Continental Drift from 2012. Well, after revisiting the film on Disney Plus, I have to say this film grew on me a little more than what it did when I first saw it a few years back. And I think this film is just a little underrated. But since this did so well, I just had a little fun with it and what have you. With, the main characters taking on Captain Gut and his band of pirates. Yeah, this was just so funny in ways. It had so much fun and adventure and all sorts of things I could get and what have you. It just provided a lot more adventure and fun. And with the additions of some, well, new voices and what have you, we get Kiki Palmer as the now grown version of Peaches, daughter to May and Ellie, and we got Jennifer Lopez on board as Shira. Pierre Dinklage is good as Captain Gut. Yeah, this film was just so much fun. I really liked it now a whole lot more. I didn't think I would, but I really got to enjoy it. So Ice Age Continental Drift, it's fun. Again, may not be the best, but hey, you don't have to take my word for it. I liked it. It was pretty good. Alright, and for the final two, this was a tough decision to make. Because we got two good films and what have you. And I really got to enjoy them. Well, one more thing. Buck Wild, of course, from the last film was absent from this, and he didn't return to a Collision Course. But I said it was okay. Alright, final two. Now, again, it was a tough decision. So, coming in at number two is... Ice Age, Dawn of the Dinosaurs from 2009. Now, this was the most successful film in the franchise, despite the mixed response, like the last film and the next film. But nonetheless, I had a lot of fun in this one. It had a lot of fun. I liked the addition of Buck Wild and Scrat-Hay, the female saber-toothed squirrel. Scrat's going against his acorn, why have you. And all the dinosaurs they encountered, this was just so much fun. I got to enjoy it. I liked the Lost World setting for it. It's just... wow. It's just so incredible. And what can I say? It just had so many fun moments. Again, if you haven't seen my reviews for this, you just gotta check them out. Still, Ice Age Dawn of the Dinosaurs still proved that a threequel can be even better than a sequel. Well, maybe almost. Yeah, but I still got to enjoy it for its story. The characters are still good, even with new ones and the atmosphere of the Lost World. Yeah, I really enjoyed this one. And finally, coming in at number one is... the one that started it all, Ice Age from 2002. Yeah, I had a lot more nostalgia for this since I've watched this numerous times. Whenever it came on HBO, I'd catch it. But anyway, I loved the original Ice Age for what it was. It just had so much fun moments and what have you. I just loved it. I love the performances we got from the whole cast. Ray Romano, John Leguizamo, Dennis Leary. Yeah, they were all good. They were all good in the other films, except they didn't return for Buck Wild. It's a movie, you know. But anyway, they were all just hysterical. I really liked it when they were trying to catch the going through those slippery ice tunnels and slides and what have you. Oh boy, Neil's like, who's up for round two? Oh boy. Yeah. But even so, this was a blast. This was the film that put Blue Sky on the map. But anyway, Ice Age is just a lot of fun. It's easily my favorite of the franchise, but you don't have to take my word for it. You be the judge and what have you. So anyway, I think Ice Age is just so fun, and it's just got all great characters, great moments, just everything from what I could get. Yeah, it's just fun. So anyway, that'll do it. So now you know my ranking of the 6 Ice Age films. There may be more coming up, but again, let's not jump to any conclusions yet. I'd like to believe that they're working on another one, but well, maybe not yet, but they announced it though before the Buck Wild movie premiered. So anyway, again, what did you think of this ranking? What's your favorite film in the Ice Age franchise? You don't have to give me your ranking. You can just tell me, you can give me your ranking or tell me what's your top favorite film of the franchise. Tell me in the comment section below. If you like this video, click the like button, subscribe to my channel, and be a part of the Big D Nation. Join me next time when I bring to you a review of another film that's got an anniversary coming up this month, and that's Liar Liar with Jim Carrey. So thank you for watching, and if you like this, consider checking out my reviews for these other films. In the upper left-hand corner is my review of DreamWorks' The Croods. The upper right-hand corner is my review for its sequel, The Croods: A New Age. Or, if you want something else, go to the bottom left-hand corner and see my review for, well, a real fun sequel from DreamWorks, that being Kung Fu Panda 2. And the bottom right-hand corner is the button you can click to subscribe. If you like rankings and reviews on movies, TV, music, video games, etc., then I'm your guy. Thanks for watching. Until next time, I'm the Big D saying, see ya.